The U.S. president's former campaign manager, Paul Manafort, has been sentenced to nearly 4 years in prison for financial crimes. Manafort will also have to pay a fine of $50,000 and the restitution of $24 million. He is due to be sentenced next week in another case related to his illegal lobbying. The charges stem from an inquiry into whether Donald Trump colluded with Russia to win the 2016 election. The Trump aide pleaded guilty last September to conspiracy against the U.S. For more on that, we're joined by Mr. Alexander Azadgan, professor of international political economy and senior geopolitical analyst. It's very nice to see you once again, Mr. Azadgan, on Press TV's World News. Now, what more can you tell us about Paul Manafort and this four-year sentence?
Hello, Gisu, and hello to your global audience. It's always good to be with Press TV as usual. They are definitely tightening the circle around the president. Let's just come right down to the point. They managed to send a very strong message to the president and those around him, the old guard, which not too many of them are left after Flynn, after Tillerson, after General Mattis, who voluntarily resigned, and Stephen Bannon, and all these people who had an agenda that was that went contrary to what the neocons wanted. The neocons that are surrounding the president at the head of the, you know, the head of the snake, forgive me for the emotional language, Mr. Bolton, always wanted to be in power after Barack Obama. It was 8 years of neolibs. Now we're going to have hopefully only another 2 years of neocons. And this man, if you dig in deep enough, not only has skeletons in his closet, he's got dinosaur skeletons of his own making. And that goes with anybody. Nevertheless, if these charges are accurate, and I'm still waiting for the fact-finding mission of the Mueller trials, if these charges are real, and what happened was that colluding and intervention of Russia in our election, this is a serious charge, which could include imprisonment, which is not going to happen either. I don't think he's even going to be impeached. The Republicans have the majority, overwhelming majority in the Senate, and the country will never go through, the Republicans pledge after Nixon that the country will never go through what they went through in the early 70s with him. It's just that, the bully, and this is the irony of it all, the bully is being bullied himself. Trump was always a chaos candidate. He's a chaos president. And certainly the fact that he wants to pull out of Syria, certainly the fact that he wants to make peace with Russia or some kind of a rapprochement, this is contrary to the warmongering agenda of the neocons, which don't realize that their project for the new American century collapsed. They don't realize that we are entering, or we have been for the past several years, in a multilateral world order, no longer an American unilateral world order, and they're a little bit behind schedule. And in my opinion, these are the last gasp of air by people who are in denial. A lot of the diehard the Trump supporter were questioning the credibility of Michael Cohen, who tested in front of Congress not too many days ago. I don't like to use this word deep state. It has become a cliche. I think the establishment of the Democratic Party is really going after the big fish himself. And I think there's another angle to this, which is the election campaigning season has started in the United States very fervently. Many interesting candidates on the Democratic part, and that's why the attacks are intensifying in order to create even a more perception of a man who colluded with a faux state in their mind, and that they would make sure this man would be a one-term president. But the psychology of this man, if you really study him, if you really study his malignant narcissism that he suffers from, is that he actually welcomes controversy. He welcomes lawsuit. I don't think he has realized he's not in New York anymore and is in Washington, and the dynamics there are very, very different. So it's coming back to him, and I don't think it's going to stop. I think it's going to intensify as the election season becomes, hotter. And I don't think there might be a way out unless he completely surrenders to the neocon agenda. I think this is a coup within the neocon elements within the Republican Party who see this man as an impediment to their goals.
Thank you very much, Mr. Alexander Azargan, professor of international political economy and senior geopolitical analyst.